Just few days before this happened, I want to tell you this incident, very intimate, but I wanted to share. I was scrolling. A computer screen, attending to some of the emails and social media and all that. Suddenly, for 2-3 days, I was feeling very little blurry. Very blur, like the vision was not, I was not able to see clearly. I was thinking, "Arey, what happened?" Because even these two eyes, I use only through third eye. It is only through the third eye, I use even these two eyes. I was thinking, maybe now I am 43. In traditional Ayurveda, they say salestram. After 40, your eyes get that salestram. Means you need to do the eye surgery. Remove the... They call it in porai in... Tamil, I don't know what you call in English. Simple eye surgery to clean the eyes and make it clear. I thought maybe now 43, time for clearing the salestram or something. I was just seeing what should be done to clean this up. Suddenly, while I was scrolling, one video appeared. Somebody has video recorded the original Arunachaleshwara, that main Garbhamandir, on Deepam Day and uploaded it. The moment I saw that video, that's it. My whole being from Manipuraga just jumped and came out through the eyes. The intensity with which it came through the eyes and started enjoying that video, this whole blurry thing disappeared. This happened, I think, maybe next day to Deepam. Because within 1 or 2 days of the Deepam, that video was uploaded. The day I saw that video, I shared it with you all. That is the day this has happened. And as far as that marabu, the practices of the tradition, taking the video record of Garbhamandir is wrong. Photograph and video recording is wrong. As per the traditions, it was wrong. I don't know whether it is wrong as per Agama, because in the Agamic documentation, there is no talk about that video recording is right or wrong. And I don't want to say that there was no video recording possible in those days. But in Agama, there is no instruction whether video recording is right or wrong. But as per the tradition, it was not allowed. I respect even if it is tradition. So, I myself will never approve if there is some temple where that video recording is not allowed. I will not allow that and I will not encourage it. But this video, my whole being just penetrated through all three eyes and gushed, I should say, literally the agni was flushed. The fire was used to flush all my three eyes. And the way it came out, all the 25 heads, 75 eyes through which that fire came out.
to enjoy that darshan of Arunachaleshwara Garbhamandir. It's literally like seeing me in my mirror. When you are best dressed and you stand in front of mirror, how you enjoy yourself. That's exactly the way I felt. Like intense experience of oneness. All that blurry, everything disappeared. Of course, I pray to Arunachala, please, please, whoever has done this, if he gets some sin or anything, please liberate him from that sin. Let him not get that sin for recording this and uploading it. Usually, I will never violate any tradition. And I will not approve anybody violating the tradition. This one video, I asked him, please, please exempt him. What he did may be wrong as per the tradition. But people like me, who can't go there physically and see, this is the way you are giving darshan. See, in those days, there are some people who can't be allowed inside the temple due to various reasons. Their lifestyle and cleanliness, hygiene, for all those reasons, they can't be allowed inside the temple. Even to bless them, Paramashiva comes out as Utsavamurti. Same way, in the modern day, there are some people who are outcasted by the human society like me, who can't be allowed into their country or into their temples. ஐயோ என்ன ஆக போதோ இவனுங்களுக்கு. Who can't be allowed into their country, into their temples? People like me who are outcasted by those human beings, even to bless me, to give darshan to me, he comes as a digital video recording, digital darshan. So I told him, nothing wrong will happen to Arunachala. He is highly possessive of Thiruvannamalai. He will never give up. So I am not telling about anything about the Arunachala or people of Arunachala. People of Arunachala never stopped me or abused me. They never stopped me entering into temple or entering into their country. Anyhow, let's leave it. Let me come to the subject. I pray to Arunachala. Please, please, if he should not get any karma, please. Even if he has violated the tradition. I don't know who actually recorded and put it, but I saw very clearly he did not have any karma. He got freed from that. Anything, if at all, is there for violating the tradition. And I also wanted to make it very clear, Arunachala and its people will be absolutely safe. You will never do anything against them, and you will always protect them. Even if they do some mistakes, he protects them. He never lets anyone curse Arunachala and its people. And I will also never curse Arunachala and its people. Even by mistake, it's impossible. Let me make it very clear. Let me come back to the subject. Intensely, when my whole being manifested through that, through my eyes, to see Arunachala, That is the cataract surgery. Now I got the word. English word, I think cataract for Salaistram. That is like cataract surgery. My eye got completely healed. That blurriness has disappeared. All those who enjoy my photograph, videograph with this kind of intensity, listen carefully. Every powerful conclusions I am revealing will become just part of you.